الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. بإذن الله تعالى هذه الليلة This evening, inshallah, المحاضرة تكون بعنوان أهمية الدعاء. The محاضرة or the topic that we're going to be speaking about is the importance of دعاء. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned a hadith that الدعاء هو العبادة. ما معنى الدعاء هو العبادة؟ يعني أعظم العبادة. It is the best type of worship. دعاء is worship, meaning that dua is the best type of worship. When we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or when we need something to happen in our lives, many of us, we ask people, so-and-so, can you help me? I need this, I need that. We rush to people instead of rushing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who answers the dua if we ask. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِلِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentions in the Quran, or Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions in the hadith, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ لِبْنِ عَبَّاسِ رَضِي اللَّهُ عَنْهُمَا. And Ibn Abbas, he was one of the mufassirs of the Quran, meaning he would tell the meaning of the Quran. He knew everything that Allah subhanahu, he knew everything that was required from him to be a scholar of the Quran. So as Muslims, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, we should listen to his hadith, as he mentioned that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in his hadith, إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. If you ask, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you... Bismillah. This one doesn't move, it stays. So if you ask, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you seek assistance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعَنْ بِاللَّهِ. Where do we hear this in the Quran? إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anything we want and everything we want, as long as it is not something that is haram. It is haram to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala things that are not allowed. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for making us understand his religion. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why are we doing all this? To go to Jannah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure us if we are sick. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us improve in our academics if we need to. But at the same time, we have to understand, with asking, you have to have the efforts and the steps, as a Muslim has to take their means, and يأتي بالأسباب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentioned in the Quran, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, and if my slaves ask me, I am near. I respond to the caller when they call to me. So let them respond to my obedience. Let them respond to my obedience. Not disobey me. Respond to my obedience. وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. And let them believe in me so they may be rightly guided. Allahu Akbar. If you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you, follow his commands. Very, very simple. You never know, one sin that you may commit, ma'asiyah wahida, one sin that you may commit may take you to the wrong path. Some people, they say, you know what, it's only a small sin. I'm only going to cheat. I'm only going to lie. Nobody sees me, I'm only going to steal something. One time, nothing's going to happen. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you. I'm going to backbite that person. Al-ghina, no problem. One time. That sin can cause you to go to the wrong path. So we don't see our sins as something small. If you see your sins as small, what's going to happen? They're going to pile up, and you're going to have a big problem. So as Muslims, I'm going to be the last to advise myself and all of us that we do not take sins lightly. And how do you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to respond to your du'as if you're doing the opposite of what He wants from you? You want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to respond to your du'as and you're doing the opposite of what you're asking for? Yes, if you're committing sins and you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you and you make du'a to help you stop those sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you. But if you expect some sort of your du'a to be accepted from you and you're not doing what you're supposed to do, this is something that as a Muslim we have to be careful of. Ibn Abbas also mentioned, قَالَ كُنْتُ خَلْفَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمْ يَوْمًا فَقَالَ يَا غُلَامْ يَحْفَدِ اللَّهِ يَحْفَظْكَ يَحْفَدِ اللَّهِ تَجِدُهُ تُجَاهَكَ وَإِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. He was riding with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day when he said, O lad, basically, O young boy, be mindful of Allah and He will protect you. Be mindful of Allah and you shall find Him with you. When you ask for anything, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be mindful of Allah. What does this mean? Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you're about to make a mistake or commit a sin, remember this is haram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching. Some people, you know what, they're so afraid of the cameras. See these cameras? They're very afraid. They don't want the cameras to see them do something wrong. They're very worried. Some of them may even wear masks. They want to do something. They want to rob a bank or something like this, they wear a mask, correct? Or if they commit a murder, they want to wear a mask and make sure nobody sees them. Some of them, they're so smart that they know where the cameras are, how to not face the camera. They are professional thieves, right? But can you hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who sees every single thing that you are doing? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees the smallest thing in the deepest place, in the darkest place. Allah sees it. Some of you might say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows all these things? How? We say, laysa kamithlihi shay. There's nothing like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's nothing like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, we should not be afraid of what people see. Because if you're afraid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you wouldn't even have to worry about cameras and what people see. So asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala requires that you, if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be helping you, make sure you protect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make sure you watch out from sins. And sins are plenty. Also, if you want to ask, we mentioned before, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who remembers the tabi'i that we spoke about a couple of minutes ago, that whenever he would make dua, would be accepted? Who remembers his name? Majid. MashaAllah, tabarakAllah. He was a special person. Why did we say he was a special person? Yes. He cared about his mom. He took care of her. So his dua would be accepted. SubhanAllah. Allah made him a person who is mustajab al dua. So very simply, bismillah ta'ala, if you want to be like him, inshaAllah, if you want to be somebody who Allah accepts your dua, make sure that you are a righteous person to your parents, as well as that you stay away from sin and stay away from haram. Now, al-isti'ana, seeking assistance. There are steps of this. For example, if I want you to assist me, for example, I'm moving to another house or something like this, and I say, can you assist me in moving my furniture? Yes, you can do that. How about I go to somebody and I say, can you help me to go to Jannah? Can you make it possible for me to go to Jannah? Is that okay? Why not? This person is an amazing person. They don't leave the masjid. You look at them, they are, you know, mashallah, amazing people. So I should go to them and ask them, no? Maybe I can touch them and I have some special, you know, dua, they'll accept my dua, no? Why not? I'll give a chance.
I mean, like, you can tell him, like, to give you tips, like, how to be a good Muslim, but he can't just do a dua, and then the man can just do whatever he wants and then go to him. It's not accepted.
So,
but, like, he can tell him tips, and then he has to follow, and the man has to follow those tips.
MashaAllah. So follow the tips, alhamdulillah. So he can tell me the way, but he can't say, you know what, the Jannah is in my hands. It's haram. This is haram. This person is calling to you to worship him, actually. So, making dua bi-Allah ta'ala is something that is very, very important. So as long as the person, if you seek his assistance, fima yaqdiru alayhi, on the things that he's capable of, okay. As opposed to what he cannot do and only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do, we cannot ask him for that. Where are the young girls today? They didn't come. No young girls today. We told them stay home, everybody. Only the young boys, mashallah. I was going to ask the sisters, the young girls, but they're not here. Inshallah, tomorrow, bi-Allah ta'ala, we'll ask him. Also, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, did he used to make dua? Of course. Who knows the dua he used to make the most? And they get a special prize for me. Because our topic today is dua. The dua he used to make the most. Yes, you are Tariq's brother. What's your name?
Ali.
What's the dua he used to make the most?
I think it says, to make his, like his dad, or I mean his uncle, or his mom.
I'll give you a tip. Kind of. We are supposed to say this dua if we are capable of reaching Laylatul Qadr. That's a tip. The dua that you should say on Laylatul Qadr. What's that dua? Ya Muqallib Al-Qulub. Thabbit
Qalbi
Al-Adin. See, you guys know, mashallah. You guys are young sheikhs, mashallah. O turner of the hearts, make my heart firm upon your religion. Who's saying this? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that means he used to make dua. He used to make dua and he was guaranteed Jannah. So making dua requires us that we put effort when we make dua. Also, we should be sincere when we make dua. You should mean it from your heart. Wallah, if you are sincere, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your dua. If you are a sincere person and you honestly want that, you want that job, bi-Allah ta'ala, you want, you know, to be somebody who Allah gives money so you can help the poor people. You want to do good in school, you want to memorize the Quran. If you are sincere, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it to you. But some people, they make dua behind the imam, they say, oh Allah give us, oh Allah give us, the imam saying this, and they're saying, Ameen, Ameen, but in their heart, they don't really mean it themselves. Or maybe they're praying, you know, Salat al-Layl, you know, that the last third of the night is the best time you should make dua. For example, now is, what is the last third of the night? 2 o'clock? 2 o'clock. In Alberta, 2 o'clock. Right? 2 o'clock until the Adhan al-Fajr is the best time you should make dua. I said why before. Why? You wake up, you make wudu, right? And you pray. Why is it so special? Yes. Because you are fresh. I need another answer. Yes, you are fresh, but what's so special about it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He comes down in a way that's befitting to His majesty. You cannot imagine, does He come down like human beings? No. In a special way that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. To the last third of to the last heaven, and He asks, who's asking me so I can give them? And some of us were sleeping. Long sleep. Some people, not sleeping is okay, at least they're gonna rest. Some people, they're wasting their time, video games. And right before Fajr, what happens? They sleep. They don't even wake up for Salatul Fajr. Or they're on their computer. Or they're doing something that's not that beneficial. But the person who is smart, al-Dakhi, wakes up, makes wudu, Allahu Akbar. In sujood, that's the closest you are to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They ask, they cry. They ask, oh Allah, give me, oh Allah, give me, oh Allah, give me. Is it hard for Allah to give you? Very easy. Very, very easy. But if you have difficulty waking up at that time, no problem. You can perhaps ask Allah to Isha, alhamdulillah. It's better than leaving it off. أفضل أن تصلي بعد العشاء. It's better for you because maybe you cannot wake up. Some people are difficult for them to wake up. Everybody knows themselves. Huh? المرء أدرى بنفسه. The human being knows themselves the best. So if you have difficulty waking up at 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock after Salat al-Isha, when you go home, alhamdulillah, اجتنى الوضوء, pray 3. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, alhamdulillah. So it's very, very easy. Very, very easy. So I have some, I know there are two students who have questions, inshallah, 3. I'm going to answer them, inshallah. But I'm going to finish with this topic, with the night, on this note. Is that we said that there are three situations, with the night, I hope you memorize this by now. I mentioned this before. Three situations where you dua has situations. That's what you were going
to
ask me?
No, I had a question, but I know the answer to this question.
Mashallah. Yes.
The first one is that Allah gives you something good in this hayah.
Good.
The second possibility is that He protects you from bad things in this hayah.
Mashallah.
The third thing is that He'll give it to you, inshallah, in the akhir.
MashaAllah. Very good, very good. You had a question?
No, I just wanted to add something. Yes. For the second answer, when he said that, Allah said in the Quran, تحبوا شيئا وهو شر لكم وعسى تحبوا تكرهوا شيئا وهو خير لكم.
MashaAllah. Very good. So basically in the Quran, the meaning of the young man, referenced the young boy, that you may like something, but it's not good for you. And you may dislike something, but it's good for you. Wallahu ya'lamu antum. Allah knows and you don't know. You don't know what's good for you. Sometimes you think that's good for me. You know, if I went to this, you know, faculty in university or college, if I got this job, you know, if I went to this school, everything's gonna work out. That's what you think. And then next thing you know, you didn't get that position, you didn't get that job, you didn't go to the university. You know, you didn't get that, you know, thing that you wanted. Allah knows why you didn't get that. Just like some people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them rich, right? But if they were poor, maybe they would not pray salah, maybe they would not give sadaqah, and so forth. So Allah keeps them rich. So Allah knows their situation. Allah makes people rich, some people poor, He knows why. We do not know why. The exact reason, we do not know why. But we have an understanding of, you know, the understanding of the wisdom behind it. So the dua that we make with Allah Ta'ala, we spoke about the time, the best time to make dua, we said it is the last third of the night. And we said if you cannot wake up the last third of the night, you do it after Isha with Allah Ta'ala. I'm talking about the witr, I apologize. But making dua the best time, that point, the best time is the last third of the night. Also, we mentioned that on Friday, in between Asr and Maghrib, right before Salat al-Maghrib, you make dua. Why? It is a time that your dua is accepted. Also, in between the Adhan and the Iqamah, your dua will be accepted. When the Maghrib makes Adhan, make dua. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask. Do not worry. Do not say, how come? Even if you have to be emotional, cry, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't worry about what people think. You're not crying to show off. You're crying because your feelings, you're letting it out. And Allah sees you. And He may give you bismillah ta'ala what you are asking for. So, in between the adhan and the iqamah. Also, do not take this lightly, but ask your parents to make dua for you. Your parents ask them to make dua for you. One of the worst things you can have is your parents make dua against you. I spoke about this before. So if you have your mom who's alive, alhamdulillah, take advantage. Your father who's alive, take advantage. And if you're from somebody who already took advantage of that, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. That's somebody who's amazing. So ask them, bismillah ta'ala, to make dua for you, so you can have khair, so you can have good things, so you can have a nice life in Allah Ta'ala. We also, in Allah Ta'ala, we also mentioned regarding, there are two types of seeking assistance. What are they, those two types of assistance that you can, one that you should seek, and one that you can't seek? Yes, now you understand, mashallah. This young boy, yes. Ghani. Yes.
Yeah.
Adam. Adam. Adam, yes. And in Somali we say Adam.
Adam.
Bin Nun.
Adam.
Sha'ab, Sha'ban, we say Shab'an. Sha'ban, Shab'an. Right, made a button, huh? Yes, Adam, tafadhal. Do you know the dua that we should seek? The assistance that we can seek? Help. Can I get help from somebody if they can help me? How about from somebody that I'd say, you know what, can you help me go to Jannah? Can you make me go to Jannah? I can ask him for that? I can ask somebody? You can't, right? Why? Who's the only one who can let you enter Jannah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. MashaAllah tabarakAllah. Bidillahi ta'ala. Tomorrow, bidillahi ta'ala's khutbah, inshaAllah, we'll be talking about an important dua. And it's called, I'm giving you a heads up, inshaAllah, Sayyidul Istighfar. InshaAllah, Sayyidul Istighfar. That's your homework, inshaAllah. Tomorrow morning when you wake up, tonight you're going to be sleeping. Tomorrow morning, try to memorize that dua, inshaAllah, because that's going to be the topic of the khutbah. I shouldn't be telling you this, but since you guys are so special, mashaAllah, I'll give you that, the topic of the khutbah, inshaAllah. Sayyidul Istighfar. You can find this dua in the book called Husn Muslim. And you can even download this Husn Muslim PDF, on PDF file, inshaAllah. I'll take the question from Majid. Yes, Majid.
For the thing where, at the beginning of the khutbah, you said people are scared of cameras and things, and Allah's watching all the time. There's this story about a sheikh and these three kids, and he gave them chocolate, and then he's like, all of you, go somewhere where no one can see you. So one went to a dark place, so that way he's no one can see me here. Someone went to he went to a place that he thought no one could see him. And then one of the kids came to the sheikh and he's like, I don't know where to hide because Allah always sees me.
Very smart that you know.
Yeah.
Huh? You can't hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can't hide. Allah sees everything. Any other questions, inshaAllah? Before, any other question? MashaAllah, JazakAllahu khairan. Tomorrow, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, we're going to have a haqqa at the same time. So, inshaAllah, make sure that you all attend. JazakAllahu khairan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.